strengthening of flexible pavement using eggshell as a filler. The main aim of the project is to increase the strength of flexible pavement by adding a suitable filler like eggshell, which is inexpensive and thus reducing the cost of construction. The objectives are to study the properties of materials used in the pavement, to examine the filler material, to prepare the samples and test them. We know even though road construction is carried out at a huge cost, they are damaged before their maintenance period. This project emphasizes on using a filler material like eggshell along with the mix so as to fill the cavities and increase its strength. From the literature review, we know that eggshell is rich in calcium, which governs the strength of bitumen mix and has a very good mechanical property. Now, these slides describe the components of flexible pavement and materials used in it and their functions. The methodology followed is represented in the slide. Each material is tested for its mechanical properties and compared using IS codebooks. Aggregates are tested for its impact value, water absorption and flakiness test, and we get the results and compare with IS 2386 1963 part 4, part 3 and part 1. The properties of bitumen are checked by performing a number of tests like penetration test, softening point, ductility test, viscosity test and specific gravity. The eggshell characteristics are also found out by analyzing it specific gravity and comparing with other journals. The percentage passing sieve number 200, which or 75 micron, is also tested. Sample preparation: take the required amount of bitumen aggregate and heat them in oven. Mix the aggregate, filler and bitumen at a temperature of 160 to 170 degrees Celsius inside the oven. Place the mixture in the bitumen compactor mold and give about 50 to 75 blows. Place the mold in the water bath at 60 degrees Celsius for 30 to 40 minutes. Measure its dimensions and weight in air. Then the sample is taken for Marshall testing, and Marshall stability and flow value are noted down. The density void analysis is carried out by calculating the unit weight, bulk density, average specific gravity and maximum specific gravity of bitumen mix. These formulas give us the presence of air voids and the voids filled with bitumen and voids filled with mineral aggregate. The slides show the readings. Next, the optimum bitumen content is to be found out. It is determined by plotting the following graphs: unit weight versus bitumen content, Marshall stability versus bitumen content, voids in final mix versus bitumen content, aggregate voids filled with bitumen versus bitumen content, and flow value versus bitumen content. All these graphs indicate that when there is an increase in bitumen content, these values also increase, but after a certain value of bitumen content, they decrease. This is because of the presence of air voids, and this increases as the bitumen content increases. The last graph, flow value versus bitumen content, shows that it is not constant, it keeps on varying, and therefore it shows that if there is more amount of air voids in the bitumen mix, then the flow value increases and thus discharge increases, and hence therefore the crack formation becomes easier and they break easily. OBC is found out by taking the average of maximum stability, maximum unit weight and median of limits of percentage air voids in the total mix. From these graphs, we take the corresponding value of bitumen content and take its average, which is 6.12%. Now, corresponding to this optimum bitumen content, the flow value and voids filled with bitumen are noted down. It is compared with the standard values, which is taken from IS 2386 codebook, and we see that they satisfy it. Conclusion: here we perform a number of laboratory tests and check its flow and stability. Based on this study, we come to a conclusion that eggshells are a good engineering material. They have good properties and they can fill the cavities of flexible pavement. It proves that when eggshell is added in the range of 10 to 15% in the mix, in which optimum bitumen content is 6 to 6.5%, then the strength of the flexible pavement is high. Thank you.